Welcome back. Now, as a part of microcontroller and its application course in the unit Real World Interfacing, in second section, we have I2C protocol. So, in this particular session, we will discuss about I2C communication protocol, as I2C is one of the most popular, well-known kind of a protocol standard. It stands for Inter Integrated Circuit Standard. It was invented by Philips Semiconductors in 1980s to provide easy onboard communication between CPU and various peripheral chips. It is very popular multi-master, multi-slave serial communication interface. It uses two bidirectional open drain data lines, that is serial data SDA and serial clock SCL. As you can see in the figure, you can interface and you can have communication between and among devices through these particular lines. So here just I have shown three slave devices uniquely at different addresses. You can have the communication, you can establish it, and you can achieve at actual communication. It is commonly used in master and slave communication, where master is nothing but the peak controller, in general microcontroller. And the slave may be anything like ADC, EEPROM, DAC, like such the devices, the way it is shown here, a clock or LCD display, anything you can connect. And unique addresses are given to communicate. In general, it is a slight difference with respect to SPI, where there is only one master. It is a synchronous serial protocol that communicates data between two devices. It is generally used for communication over short distance. It is slow speed protocol as compared to SPI communication. This device has 7 bit or 10 bit unique address. So to access these devices, master has to address them by 7 bit or 10 bit unique address. It is used in many applications like reading RTC, accessing external EEPROM memory. It is also used in sensor modules. So many more applications are there. As far as communication is considered, it is carried out through registers. So to establish I2C communication between devices, we have to configure the particular peak controller. Like to do this, some registers are to be taken care. First one is SSPBUF. It is a serial transmit receive buffer register in I2C protocol. This is data register which is used for transmission and reception of data. Second one is SSPSR, that is MSSP shift register. It is a shift register which is used to shift data in and out on SDA line. It is not directly accessible. And the third one is SSPADD register. So this is the address register. In master mode, it is used to decide or generate the baud rate or bit rate. So in general, in case of I2C protocol, as far as data format is considered, it is having slave address, then read-write line, then acknowledgement, data, and again there is also option called not acknowledgement, that is NATK. So through this it can communicate. Single message it can start with prior to any transaction on the bus, a start condition is issued, and then the further process will start of transmission. And it is terminated using end. So I will just give you the overview, that is how exactly it works. So in first step, the master device issues a start condition to inform all the slave devices so that they listen on the serial data line. In the second step, the master device sends the address of the target slave device, which is compared with all slave devices addresses as connected to SCL or SDL lines. If any one address matches, then the device is selected and the remaining all devices are disconnected. In the next step, the slave device with a matched address received from the master responds with an acknowledgement to the master. Thereafter, communication is established between both the master and the slave device. In step number 4, both the master and slave receive and transmit the data depending upon whether the communication is read or write. And in step 5, the master can transmit 8 bit of data to receive, which replies with a 1 bit of acknowledgement. So transmitting and receiving the information step by step serially with respect to clock pulses is nothing but I2C protocol. It is an intersystem and short distance protocol. It is used within the circuit board to communicate the master and slave devices. It is using two lines, as I mentioned, SCL and SDE. Now, for example, if you want to connect with peak, then in case of peak 18F4550 master synchronous serial protocol module, that includes I2C protocol. So here there is RB1 and RB0, these two lines, pin number 33 and port 34, made available from port B for making the connection. The MSSP module, as a part of peak microcontroller, allows I2C and other synchronous serial protocols. This is a general structure where there will be SSP BUF, I2C engine at the master side, and at the peripheral side there will be control, and accordingly the actions are carried out. For baud rate generation, in general it is going to follow this particular rule. So load that particular generator value in SSP ADD register, then the above formula will be used, and in case of slave mode, the SSP ADD register holds the address of the slave device. So the registers involved, let us have a small kind of a overview. So first register is SSP CON1, MSSP CONTROL1 register. So it's WCOL, that is write collision detect bit. Then it is 1, the register is written while it is still transmitting previous word, and 0, then there is no collision. Then SSPOB, so this is receive overflow indicator flag. So 1 byte is received with SSPBUF register is still holding the previous word, and if it is 0, then there is no overflow. Then bit 5, SSPEN, synchronous serial port enable bit. It is 1, enables serial port and configures SDA and SCL pin as a serial port pin. If it is 0, then disable serial port and configure these pins as GPIO. Bit 4 is CKP, so SCK release control bit in slave mode. If it is 1, then release clock. If it is 0, then holds clock loop. Not used in master mode. And as far as bit 3 to 0, 4 bits are considered. Then address wise, it is 0110, I2C slave mode 7-bit address. 0111, it is slave mode 10-bit address. 1000, it is master mode clock, which is F oscillator divided by 4 into SSP ADD plus 1. 1011, it is I2C firmware controller master mode. 1110, it is I2C slave mode 7-bit address with start and stop interrupt enabled. And 1111, it is I2C slave mode 10-bit address with start and stop interrupt enabled. The second register is SSP CON2. Here first one is GCN, it is a global enable. Then ACK, this is acknowledgement status bit. So it is 1, that was not received from the slave, and if it is 0, then signal was received from the slave. Bit 5 is ACKDT, it is acknowledged data bit. This bit is used when master requests to slave devices for reading and receiving of data. If it is 1, not acknowledged, which tells others devices stop sending data. And if it is 0, then acknowledge, which tells device send another data. Then bit 4 is ACKEN, acknowledge sequence enable bit. 1, initiate acknowledge sequence on SDA and SCL pins and transmit ACKDT data bit, which is automatically cleared by hardware. And if it is 0, then acknowledge sequence is disabled or not in use. Bit 3 is RCEN, it is a receive enable bit. So it is going to enable receive mode for I2C. It is 0, disable receive mode. Then bit 2 is PN, stop condition enable bit. 1 is equal to enable stop condition and cleared automatically by hardware, and 0, stop condition is idle. Bit 1 is RACN, restart condition enable bit. 1, enable repeated start condition and cleared automatically by hardware, and 0 is repeated start condition is idle. Bit 0 is SCN, start condition enable bit. It is 1, enable start condition and cleared automatically by hardware. If it is 0, then start condition is idle. Then third one is SSP STAT, MSSP status register. So SMT bit, slew rate control bit, in master or slave mode, one slew rate control disabled for standard speed mode, 100 kHz and 1 MHz. If it is zero, slew rate control enabled for high speed mode, 400 kHz. Bit 6 is CKE, it is SM bus select bit, 1 enable SM bus specific input and 0 disable SM bus specific input. Bit 5 is D slash A, data address bit. In slave mode, 1 indicates that the last byte received or transmitted was data, and if it is 0, indicates that the last byte received or transmitted was address. Then bit 4 is a stop bit. So it is indicates the stop bit has been detected last, that is if it is 1, and if it is 0, then stop bit was not detected last. Bit 3 is S, that is start bit. 1 indicates that start bit has been detected last, and 0 indicates start bit was not detected last. Then bit 2 is R slash W, read write information bit. In slave mode, if it is 1, then read, 0, then write. In master mode, if it is 1, then transmit in the is in progress, and if it is 0, transmit is not in progress. Bit 1 is UA, update address bit. It is used for 10-bit slave mode only. 1 indicates that a user mode, user needs to update addresses, address in SSP 8 address register. And 0 indicates address does not need to be updated. Bit 0 is BF bit, buffer full status bit. In transmit mode, 1 SSP BUF is full, and if it is 0, then SSP BUF is empty. In receive mode, if it is 1, then it is full. If it is 0, then it is empty again. Does not include acknowledgement and stop bit. Now, in general, if we think about the processor or the module, which how it is to be written, then this is general flowchart. Like you can in the beginning set up the variables, set up the ports, and then configure I2C. Send start condition, send control in byte and wait for acknowledgement. And next is send address byte and wait for acknowledgement. Send data byte and wait for acknowledgement. And send then stop bit condition. So this is done. Like write in case of read operation. So start. Set up variables, set up port, configure I2C, send start condition, send control in byte and wait for acknowledgement. Send address byte and wait for acknowledgement, send restart condition, send control out byte, wait for acknowledgement, get data byte, send NACK condition, send stop condition. So this way you can have the general say flow or the process. For programming purpose, these are some of the basic steps which you need to follow. First of all, configure port B.0 and port B.1 as input pins. Also configure SSP STAT and SSP CON2 register. Enable I2C by setting SSP EN bit in SSP CON register. Also select master slave mode. Set frequency of I2C communication by loading value in SSP ADD register in master mode. Now this is the general routine. We want to set B0 and B1 port. So I've just as a part of this small session sample routines which we need to write when I2C communication is established. Those I have just one by one mentioned here. It is not giving you the actual full program or sample program, but it is just I've covered the routines which you need to write. So first is the initialization routine. Here, so here it is B0, port B0 and port B1 bits. They are set as input bits. Then SSP STAT, so 0x80 slew rate disabled, other bits are cleared. Then SSP CON1, that is 0x28 enable SSP port for I2C master mode under clock frequency. Then SSP CON2 is made 0, SSP address bit rate, so whatever is that 100 kHz say for example, and then SSP T1 enable the interrupt and IF bit is 0. Then start communication, send start plus to slave device by setting bit in SEN in SSP CON2 register. Then wait for SEN bit to clear. Also check S bit in SSP STAT register, which indicates start bit is detected or not, and then send device slave address along with write operation and check for the acknowledgement signal. So here we have done like this. So for example, a routine is written, character I2C start routine, character slave write address, so this is pcon to bits.sen equal to 1, start pulse send. Then while this particular bit.sen wait for completion of start pulse, then sspif is equal to 0, and if that is start is detected last, then return 0 and write slave device address. So we can like this, we can write. This is just the sample, not the full-fledged module. Then we have to monitor BF flag or SSPIF, which will set when transmission or reception of a byte is complete. So I2C bus is ready, check BF flag and again read write bit in SSP STAT register for finding I2C bus is ready or not. So for that, while suppose wait if bit collision interrupt flag is set, you have to check that, and then wait for buffer full and read write flag. So while SSP STAT bits.bf, so we are checking that, and then it is to be disabled. So SSP IF is made 0. Also SSP IF flag can be used to poll the complete byte transmit receive status. Also it is necessary to clear SSP IF interrupt flag through the software. So we have to do that. Then next is for ready, while this condition and then clear it. So I2C ready, then read write, that is copy write data to SSP BUF register to for transmission and wait for completion of transmission. So for that we are going to write SSP BUF equal to data I2C ready. So while not equal to, you have to complete that. So that above loop is taking care, that is ready routine, I2C underscore ready routine, that is invoked here. And then if ACK STAT return 1, else return 2. So we can check the ACK. After write, if we want to stop I2C communication, then set PN bit in SSP CON2 register and wait for PN bit to clear. So here you can have just the like checking P bit in SSP STAT register, which is just indicating the whether the stop bit is detected or not. So that you can just see I2C ready, PN equal to 1, then while PN SSP I equal to 0, then SSP STAT bits dot P detected last, return 0. So that you can do. Then read write device, the data, enable receive mode by setting bit RCN in SSP CON2, then wait for buffer flag to set, which is set when complete byte is received. Read the buffer immediately. After reading one byte, set acknowledgement signal if we want to read next data, else send negative acknowledgement, which tells that we don't want to read next data. To do this, ACKDT is 1 or 0 and ACKEN should be enabled. So this is the case where read data from location and send acknowledgement or negative acknowledgement depending upon the parameter. So I2C read is buffer equal to 0, RCN is 1, and then while SSP statbits.bf is going to transfer that SSP BUF contents into buffer. If flag equal to 0, I2C acknowledgement routine, else I2C not acknowledgement, that is negative acknowledgement rather, I2C, then I2C ready. So this way you can invoke those small routines one by one. For acknowledgement, what we will write is byte I2C ACK. So ACK DT is equal to 0 and ACK enable equal to 1. And for negative acknowledgement, ACK DT equal to 1 and ACK enable is 1. So this way you can have the negative acknowledgement and that is NACK and ACK signal. So altogether, in general, if we talk about I2C, then just to summarize here, I2C is implemented in PEEK microcontroller by hardware module, that is nothing but the inbuilt module MSSP, that is master synchronous serial port, This module is built into many different PEEK microcontroller devices, like it is available in PEEK 18 F series, which is of our interest. It allows I2C serial communication between two or more devices at a high speed and communicates with other PEEK micro devices and many peripheral ICs on the in the market. I2C is a synchronous protocol that allows master device to initiate communication with slave device. Data is exchanged between these devices. It is a bidirectional, implemented by an acknowledge-based system. The acknowledge system or ACK system allows data to be sent in one direction to one item on the I2C bus, and then that item will ACK to indicate the data was received. So this way it is carried out. It's a very straightforward and simple. In PEEK microcontroller, you have this inbuilt facility of MSSP, and effectively you can use it in many applications. Thank you.